Hi there everyone. Welcome to part 3 of our Fiji tutorial videos. Today we're going to cover FRAP analysis, which is fluorescence recovery after photobleaching. And so we're going to run through a few plugins that are required for the types of analyses that we usually do. And today we're going to focus on a test example of yeast FRAP assay. So I have here an image of a yeast cell. And if we zoom in here on the yeast cell, we can see that this particular puncta is what we're going to bleach away. So there's our fully bleached state, and then we can watch that recovery happen over time. We have some photobleaching in the background, but that's okay. So the first thing we want to do is draw an ROI around this puncta, and so you can choose any of the ROIs up here that you find necessary. And for me, I know that I'm going to focus on an ellipse. So if you right-click on this button, you normally have oval selected by default, and you can click elliptical. So once I have that tool selected, I'm going to draw on my puncta an ellipse, and I'm going to fit it tightly around my puncta and cover as little background around that puncta as possible. Once I've placed my ROI on the image, I'm going to go ahead and run create spectrum JRUV1. So once I am ready to do that, I click on the toolbar and type L. That brings up the search window. And then I can look for create spectrum. Once I have selected that plugin, I click on my image window so it's active, and then click run. And this is going to ask us for the statistic that we want to run, and by default it's average. You can choose any that you like, but we're going to use average. Click OK. And this is our first plot window that we're going to use for this one data point. So you want to save this as a plot object, so that's your file type there. These are your defaults, and click OK, and then you can save that as a PW2 file. You're gonna go ahead and repeat that for every image that you have in your data set, and I've already done that, so I'm going to show you all the data that I have. So I have just a bunch of recovery windows that all look pretty much the same. Okay, so now I want to combine all the trajectories into one window. So I'm gonna go back to my search window, type combine all trajectories, and now I'm going to run that plugin. I want to combine all series, and I want to go ahead and delete the originals. Since I've already saved all the individual files, I can delete the windows that are on the screen. It does not delete them from memory or from disk, it just deletes the ones that are in the Fiji memory inactive. So click delete and then click OK. So that now gives us a new window that has all of the recovery curves in one window. Go ahead and save that as a new window. And then for the ease of fitting, we want to normalize these trajectories. And so we're going to run that plugin now. Normalize trajectories. So I'm going to select my window and then select run. And I have a bunch of different normalization options here, and it's defaults to max. But what we want to do is use min-max. Min-max is going to make the maximum of all the curves at 1, the minimum of all the curves at 0, and then all of the recoveries will overlay better. So this is going to give us the opportunity to more readily compare curves to one another later. So I'm going to select min-max and click OK. So that gives me yet a new window. I'm going to go ahead and close my other one so I don't run my next plugins on the wrong window. I'm going to save this as a new window. And now we can do two different things. We can generate an average curve, and we can fit all of this data. So let's do fit first. So that's batch FRAP fit JRUV1. So I'm gonna select that plugin in my search. So I'm gonna select that plugin, make sure to select my window, and then click run. So now I know that I have 5 frames before FRAP, so that means 5 frames here at max height before I FRAP anything. So for you it could be 0, it could be 1, it could be infinity, whatever you like. And then I have my bleach region, and then now it's asking me how many frames I want to analyze. I could do the whole range, but I know I have some photo bleaching, so to account for that I'm going to do about 60 time points. So I'm going to put 60 in there. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm going to put 60 in here, and I'm going to leave my minimum tau and maximum tau to default, And I'm going to make an assumption at this point that it's a single component recovery. So once I have my inputs selected, I'm going to click OK. And now I get a new window that has all of my curves in it, truncated to 60 because that's what I said I wanted to fit. I have a table out with all of my fit components. And you can go through at the bottom of this window and look at each curve individually. So if you click through, you can look at the fit for each individual curve and make sure that they're all fit well. Okay, so once I have these fits, I can go ahead and save this window as an Excel sheet so that I can do whatever I want to in Python or Excel or whatever to fit my tau values. You notice I have no tau values that are two frames. One's pretty close, but not two, and none of them are 113. So I know that all of my curves were actually fit, and so that I can trust all of these values. These taus are in frames, not time. So you'll need to convert the time between frames for your particular data set to get these tau values into units of actual time. So that allows me to calculate average tau values, average percent recovery, things like that. So the other thing that I would want to do to generate an average curve is use average trajectories JRUV1. So in my search window, average trajectories JRUV1, again, select my plot window, click run. My statistic will be average. I want the average of all the curves. And then I can choose to add error or not error. And so sometimes I like to include the error separately. And so you can run this once with just average and no errors. And then you can do it a second time to include errors. And I'm going to use the standard error for my error on the curve. Go ahead and click OK. And now I've generated a new curve with error bars at every single point. And I can save that as a new plot window as well, using the same default loading as before. So this has been a tutorial for FRAP analyses and how to fit individual curves to generate average tau values and percent recovery values, and also how to generate an average curve with error bars. Thanks a lot for watching. See you next time.